Hi, I'm Melanie. And I accepted Christ as my Savior when I was 10 or 11, something after my summer after my fifth grade at Pine Cove Camp. And at the time, I didn't really understand baptism, I guess. I was baptized as an infant and sprinkled on my head. And I think it was kind of more of a baby dedication for my parents. I struggled with, you know, if I had to be baptized again or how this really all worked. And I kind of just put it off on the back burner because I wasn't sure how to handle it. As I got a little older, as I met my husband, he had been baptized as a believer's baptism after he had accepted Christ. And we kind of wrestled with it and talked with it back and forth about, you know, what you were supposed to do, what you weren't supposed to do, what the Bible says about it. And I still wasn't, you know, quite sure because I really hadn't read it for myself. And so I kind of struggled with it some more and spoke to another friend that I had grown up with. So she sent me, you know, all these verses and things, and I just prayed over it. And I realized that the Lord was calling me to be baptized. And but I was hesitant to respond, I guess, because it was embarrassing to me, I thought. And I didn't want to get up in front of the church and explain that I had been a Christian for all these years, but that I hadn't, you know, followed through like I should have. And so I came to the fact that I needed to have it done. And so we started attending Oak Ridge about February, March of this year after we moved here from Texas. And when we took class 101, it was just kind of an open door kind of thing, like this is the next step and this is what you do after you've been, you know, if you've accepted Christ as your Savior. And so it was a no pressure kind of thing to just walk in and say, yeah, this is what I needed to do and this is what needs to be done in my life and this is my, you know, next step in my faith. For me, it's really just been about an act of obedience. I know that this is what God has called me to do, and the longer I sat still and didn't do what I was supposed to do, the more I realized that I was personally suffering for it because I wasn't able to reach my potential. You know, I kind of had reached a plateau, like a level that I couldn't keep going unless I was obedient. And just by saying yes in the last, you know, couple of months, I've noticed that it's almost like a little of, you know, the ball is off my shoulder. And it's not a burden that I'm carrying around. I know I've done the right thing.